online service, and welcome if this is your first time joining us. We're currently studying a series called Finishing Strong. And in this series, we are deeply studying a question that is, what will happen to all Christians in the future? Well, the answer is that all Christians one day will get to see Jesus in His glory and that we'll get to live with Him forever. Isn't this amazing? Well, let's get started by playing a game called What's the Cost? And you're going to figure out which item is going to cost more.
Stand strong.
Are you a type of person where it doesn't matter how much it costs, you just have to have it? Or are you willing to give up because you just don't think it's not worth paying for the cost that they're asking? Well, today's Bible story, we're going to be reminded of the cost that Jesus paid so that our sins can be forgiven. There are 66 books in the Bible, and we're studying one verse from each book. So that means we'll get to study 66 verses together in order. Today, we're going to discover the 14th book of the New Testament. So let's get started by reviewing the 13 books. 3, 2, 1, go! Matthew, Mark, Luke, John, Acts, Romans, 1 Corinthians, 2 Corinthians, Galatians, Ephesians, Philippians, Colossians, 1 Thessalonians, and finally today's 14th book is called 2 Thessalonians. What was that again? 2 Thessalonians. And today's power verse, it comes from chapter 3:16. Let's read it together in one voice. Go. We pray that the Lord of peace will give you peace at all times and in every way. May the Lord be with you, all of you. Amen. Here's my power verse journal, and I added today's 14th book, 2 Thessalonians, and the power verse. I love this verse because it reminds us that God gives us peace at all times and in all ways. In God's peace, it's not the worn, torn peace of this world. This peace is inner peace. It's a perfect peace. In God's peace, it's beyond our understanding of what God promised us to give. God says that He is going to give us peace, and that means that He is going to always guard our heart. God's peace, it gives us rest, hope, comfort, and refreshment.
I've got peace like a river in my soul.
talking about Apostle Paul for a while now. Was Paul always a champion for the church? No, he wasn't. You remember, he used to persecute Christians and he wanted the church to stop growing. But everything changed for Paul when he was on his way to Damascus. That's when he met Jesus. And that's how he decided to follow Jesus rest of his life and tell others about Jesus. And he got arrested, he got thrown into prison just because he was sharing the gospel. But nothing stopped Paul. He still continued to share the good news. And last week, we shared how Paul was on his way to Rome, but there was a shipwreck, but Paul still trusted that God was going to rescue him. And Paul was right. God allowed Paul to get to Rome safely. Now, today's story, it continues, and it's called Brothers in Christ. We're going to find out more.
When Paul was a prisoner in Rome, he met a man named Onesimus. Onesimus was a servant. He had run away from his master, Philemon. Philemon was Paul's friend. Paul told Onesimus the good news about Jesus, and Onesimus believed in Jesus. Onesimus helped Paul, and Paul wanted Onesimus to stay with him. So Paul wrote a letter and told Onesimus to take the letter back to Philemon. Paul wrote, "Dear Philemon, I am writing to you because I love you. I want you to do the right thing. I am getting old, and I am in prison because I tell people about Jesus. I met Onesimus and told him about Jesus, and he believed. I want him to stay with me, but I want your permission first." Onesimus is a believer now. Maybe this is why he left for a little while, so that he could come back to you as a brother instead of a servant. He is our friend and brother in Christ. Please welcome him like you would welcome me. If he owes you anything, I will pay it. Philemon, I would be so happy if you agree to this. I know you will do what is right. Paul asked Philemon to get a room ready for him. Paul hoped to visit Philemon soon. Paul offered to pay Onesimus' debt to make peace between him and Philemon. In this way, Paul acted like Jesus, who makes peace between God and man. Jesus took the punishment we deserve for our sin. He paid our debt so that we can be forgiven and welcomed by God.
Today's story comes from the book of Philemon. Now, this book was a letter that Paul wrote to his friend Philemon, who was a slave owner. And the reason why Paul wrote a letter to Philemon is because one of Philemon's slaves ran away. And do you remember what Paul asked and what Paul said in his letter? Well, let's read verse 12 in one voice. Go. I am sending him back to you, and with him I am sending my own heart. I wanted to keep him with me to help me while I am in prison for the good news. By helping me, he would be serving you. But I did not want to do anything without asking you first. Then any favor you do for me will be because you want to do it, not because I forced you to do it. Paul loved Onesimus. I mean, Paul took care of him and he loved him so much as if he was his own family member, like a son or a brother. And do you remember what Paul asked Philemon to do? Well, let's read that in our scriptures. Verse 15, go. Onesimus was separated from you for a short time. Maybe that happened so that you could have him back forever. Not to be a slave, but better than a slave, to be a loved brother. I love him very much, but you will love him even more. You will love him as a man and as a brother in the Lord. If you think of me as your friend, then accept Onesimus back. Welcome him as you would welcome me. Paul encouraged Philemon to love Onesimus as brothers in Christ. And Paul expected Philemon to welcome Onesimus back. I mean, the Bible says that without Jesus, we would be sinners. And sin separates us from God. And Paul was willing to pay everything that Onesimus owed to Philemon. And this is a perfect example of what Jesus did for us. Jesus paid our debt. He died for us so that we could be free from all sins. You know, Jesus, he loves us. He welcomes us. And this shows that Jesus treats us as his brothers and sisters. Just like Jesus died for us and he forgave all of our sins, we are to treat our brothers and sisters just like that Jesus treated others. Jesus welcomed us, so we need to welcome others and we need to forgive others. We are to take care of each other, encourage one another, and forgive them if they do any wrong, because that's what Jesus did. And when we do this, we're letting God know how much we love him. And by doing this, we are staying focused on his mission until Jesus returns. Isn't it amazing that Jesus died for our sins? If it wasn't Jesus, we would be separated from God. But because Jesus paid all of our debt, we are forgiven and we are welcomed by God. Isn't it wonderful that, hey, we are God's children? And we as Christians in the future, what will happen to us? We will get to see Jesus in his glory and we will get to live with him forever. Let's all get up and let's praise his name.
Oh, oh, oh.
Let's all close our eyes and pray. Heavenly Father, thank you so much for your word. Your word is true and your word is trustworthy. We can study it and learn about loving one another through your example and through Paul's letter. Help us to treat others the way you have treated us, as brothers and sisters. We love you, Lord, and always help us to encourage one another. In Jesus' name we all pray, amen. Today, how Paul asked Philemon to forgive and welcome back Onesimus as his brother in Christ. In Romans 15:7 says, Christ has accepted you, so you should accept others. This is a way for us to let God know how much we love him, and we are honoring him by showing God's love and forgiveness to others. So it's so important that we take care of others, take care of our brothers in Christ through Jesus. So I want to challenge you this week to find that one friend. I'm pretty sure there is always that one friend that it was so hard for us to forgive. I know I do. Well, this week, I am going to pray and forgive that friend because the Bible says, that we show him how much we love him and we honor him when we love, when we accept, and when we forgive others. Hey guys, I had an amazing worship with you, and don't forget, that we as believers, we are to welcome and treat and love and forgive our brothers and sisters in Christ. So make sure to stay safe because I want to see you again next week. You guys, take care. Bye.